Okay, everybody, we're going to talk a little Game of Thrones here, all right? So, last episode, last hurrah, so here you go. Spoiler alert, going to be talking about it, going to be talking about some things that happened in the finale. So if you don't watch it, see you later. First and foremost, man, I love the show. I love the show. If you'd asked me 10 years ago, Kretchy, you're going to love a show that's got dragons in it. I've been like, all right, I don't think so. But here I am. This drew me in like no TV show I ever had. It was like watching a great, well-produced movie every single week. And I love the ride. I've loved this season. I know a lot of people had complaints about it. But guess what? TV shows don't go the way you want. They're not there to make everybody feel good. You know, they follow a story, and I don't have to agree with it. There's certainly things I didn't, you know, necessarily dig, but I loved it. I mean, I miss Lyanna Mormont. She was a badass, and I really wanted her to stick around and kick some more ass. Ser Jorah, too. After all that guy did for Khaleesi, I wanted him to make it to the end. It wasn't to be. I expected there to be a higher body count in the last episode. Shame on me. I thought for sure that Arya was going to be the one to kill Dany. Wrong answer. Thought maybe Jaime Lannister wasn't really dead. Wrong answer. And, you know, the whole thing about him and Ciri getting, you know, I mean, Ciri, him and Cersei getting, you know, with a building collapsing on, that's the way to go. Doesn't fit the violent death that I wanted her to have. But, you know what? I get it. It makes sense. He went through everything he had to do because he couldn't live without her, and she was his love of his life. So what if she was his sister? So what? But it made sense in that way. You know, the final episode wasn't as exciting as I wanted to, but I understand. You had the kind of excitement with the crazy Night King, the battle with the Night King and the White Walkers and Arya with the big stab job. It was kick-ass. It was the best moment of any TV show I've ever seen. Plus, the next week, they followed that up with the torching of King's Landing. That was amazing. You kidding me? That was brutal. So they had to slow it down. I get it. What I don't get is the incessant bitching and whining that the fans are all of a sudden they hate the show because what? Because it didn't the way you wanted? You know what? When the Patriots lost the freaking Super Bowl to the New York Giants, yeah, I was bummed. But I'm a Patriots fan. Win or lose, I suck it up, Buttercup. Get back in the friggin' game. God, the bitching and the whining. Oh, then the petition. Seriously? Grown adults are going to sign a petition to have HBO remake that? Are you high? What are you thinking? God, what a waste of time. Losers. Write that TV show again. It's the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my friggin' life. And I'm old. Heard a lot of dumb shit. God's sake. Anyway, I loved it, though. I loved it. Not every decision. I didn't agree with every decision. You know, but man, you got to admit, when Dany looked at Jon Snow with them eyes and got right up to him like, I love you. We'll rule it together. I loved you. I really love you. You see those eyes? Crazy eyes. That chick had to go. Because if he didn't do her, she was going to do him, guaranteed. Because he was the threat to everything she ever wanted. Oh, she made those eyes. I'm like, ah, she's got to go. I did, however, think that Arya was going to kill her. I did. I was hoping for that. I wanted Arya to get a little bit last-minute revenge. But alas, the Night King was her last body. Thought maybe she'd get back together with Gendry. But that wasn't going to happen either. But you know what? It was probably my favorite television show of all time. And to the people who are like, I'm the 1% who didn't watch Game of Thrones. Good for you. Good for you. Why do you have to write and tell people what you don't do? Guess what? I don't bench press 300 pounds. You don't see me writing about it. I don't freaking practice yoga. I don't go, I'm the 1% who doesn't do yoga. Good. Good for people who do it. Good for, go be happy. If you don't like it, just go be happy. Find something you like. Write about that. God forbid. This country, people start talking about things that they enjoy. Everybody's got to take a shit on them. God, it doesn't make sense. It drives me crazy. Anyway, I loved it. I loved the show. Yeah, and the ending was a little underwhelming, you know? I mean, Bran, the guy had one face. You know that Bill Belichick shirt that says the faces of Bill Belichick, sad, happy, all the same face? I'm going to make that shirt with Bran's face. He had one face the entire show. The whole show. Unbelievable. And he's the king. Anyway, but you know what? I'm cool with it because it does have a poetic sense about it. So anyway, just things that I may not understand about the ending, but I did love it nonetheless. So there's my take on Game of Thrones. And hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. And if you didn't, I don't care. Okay? See ya.